So my introduction's already given by Vishal sir. So let's move ahead. So today's agenda. So we're going to talk about what is RPA. RPA stands for Robotic Process Automation. We're going to talk about how it is used currently in businesses, different business use cases, different products or tools which are available in market, and we will see the top three top products. What are the trends right now going on? Because now this is getting mature day by day. So what are the upcoming trends? What are the career options for students and professionals? And how you can start your RPA learning journey? So are we good on this? So if you're able to see my screen, my voice is clear. Just type, let's start. So I want some comments with words, say, let's start.
Please go ahead. Please go ahead. Everything is fine.
Perfect. Okay, guys. So we have 32 students. Great. So let's move next. So we're going to talk about what is RPA. I'm going to start there. Now, why, you know, I just want to give a perspective here that why you should be know about it. What are the, you know, why before we going into session, I just want to bring this perspective that as a RPA right now, career wise, these are the options. Right, in US or UK, Australia and India, these are the our starting as a career, you find a beneficial compared to other technology, other areas, how this is differentiate, and you find the different role on the right side. You see different role where you see that based on different role, what kind of professional, you know, kind of benefit you can get based on that. So this is just a give you boost and make you aware that we're going to have a you know, very progressive and beneficial career ahead. So now let's move ahead. Now, before I just move to next slide, which is all about RPA, these are all keywords related to RPA, right? It has RPA in between, and then all the related keywords, technology words are all around. So if you're seeing this first time, no issue in that. Just want some feedback through comments. What are the other emerging technology, or what are the names you know in emerging technology that you are aware? You may have heard on television or videos or through seniors or your faculties or by your interest. What are the different technologies you have, you know this so far? So just type your those technologies name, those are trending names, those emerging, you know, capabilities coming in market. So just I want to know what are your understanding on new emerging technology. Emerging means upcoming technologies, the latest one. So I want your feedback. Obviously, RPA is one. That's why we're going to talk. But I just want to have my understanding that what you guys are aware so far. So just type it in your comments box so I can just have a glance, and then we'll continue on our next. Great, blockchain, AI, ML, great. Yes. I need participation, friends, so that it would be useful. Automation of processes. Yes, we're going to discuss that today. NLP. What is the full form of NLP? It is language, natural language processing, or neuro-linguistic programming. So just type full form for benefit of everybody. Data science, yes. Natural language processing, yes. So now Alexa, Siri, OK Google are doing that, right, guys? Even it doing in regional language. So now Hindi language processing also happening in Alexa, Siri, OK Google also. Great. Some more digital realities. Great. Alexa, AWS, Hindi. Very good. Guys, I need more participation from you, and let's start this next journey. So great. So most of you are aware, right? At least you're aware that these are the technologies, or these are the trends, right? And then trends are supported by technology, technology supported by tools, tools supported by different companies. And that is how a career we can start. Augmented reality, great. And now you see on the screen, you have robotic process automation. And then we have related keywords, which talks about, you know, business processes, artificial intelligence, software, all these are related words related to RPA. So if this might be first time for you, if not aware, then also good. So now next move ahead. So three keywords, right? Robotic process automation. So we'll just understand in a simple way that what is the meaning of RPA and then how RPA is implemented by different tools, right, or different ways. Robotic process automation, three words. Okay, so what is RPA? Robotic process automation. So three words I'm going to discuss, and this is first time you, if you are hearing, then also you will learn simplistic way. Robotics, right? First word is robotic. So anything that mimic human action, anything that, you know, kind of help you out, right? You must hear a real robots in movies or in real time. You must have seen outside in industries, factories, on shop floor, in hospitals, in research lab. You must have seen different type of robots. Here we are not talking about physical robot. In RPA, this robotic means physical action of human, but on the software side, on the technology side, on the infrastructure, IT infrastructure related only, right? It's not a physical software. These are all digital robots. These are all technology robots. These are all software robots. But robotic means same thing, mimicking human action. What is process? So you understand the meaning of robotic, right? Now, process. So process means a sequence of activities, sequence of tasks, right, to reach to a result. It will have input, set of activities, and output. Output for some new activities or a real outcome. That is the process is. So process, in our example, you can take any example, right? Anything that you do in a systematic way, which has start point, which has you know, kind of workflow, task flow, and end result. That means a process. So mimicking human action on a process with automation. Automation means what? That means it doesn't require our intervention, right? Just an example, like kind of fan is going on, right? Fan is automation in my room. Why? Because fan doesn't require human intervention, right? It's just keeping on. That is one simple automation. But here, if you talk about in RPA, again, because it is automation, it reducing or replacing our human intervention. So anything which can be done, which can mimic our action, means professional actions in a systematic way without our intervention, that is called RPA. So you sometimes you may confuse with the real robots. This is not true. These are all software robot. These are all technical robot, digital robot. We call bot. It's all about processes. So this will be apply where all the systematic things are happening and automation, which are human intervention not required. So I hope this is clear basic definition of RPA, and you see the picture where these bots are working on computers, right? And real robots, you will see those are works in factories, those are work in hospital, research lab, maybe traffic lights also, right? Indore, I heard that there are robots who work on traffic signals. So these are not that, these are more like software robot. Shall I move ahead? Okay, so next is what? That what is robotic automation is what is not, right? Because this would always be confusion whether this is RP or not. This is robot or not. This is process or not. This is automation or not. So just to make clear that upper side, what we talks about, that if these conditions are applicable, then we call it RPA, automation, and this condition doesn't suffice and below condition suffice, then these are not RPA. Just an example, if any humanoid robot, humanoid means a physical robot or which has like a, you know, kind of a look and feel of a human or animals or, you know, some sort of character, then those are not RPA. Those are real robot. And then whatever we are replicating our desktop action, yes, that falls in RPA category. Virtual robots, right, that integrate with our different software or processes or tools within organization and sometimes outside organization also. So this is just a basic definition of RPA, what RPA is, what RPA not. So far good. So far, I just want some feedback from you guys. Am I going slow? Am I going fast? If there is any questions, please ask in between. I will take that in between as well as toward the end of session also. So need some feedback, whether should we move ahead or any questions so far from all of you guys. Feel free to type in so we can move ahead. Perfect. Okay. So now let's go to what are the, how RPA used in business, right? So all this technology, whatever we use, right? Whether you use a mobile app, whether you use any development programming, whether you use any tool, all is about to solving business problem. Now, how RPA is going to solve business problem? So what are the different use cases? A common use cases, I would say, not very complex one. I will go through only simple one. And how these different domains, domains means different industries, different business lines, how they use RPA, and then obviously we'll go further. So let's move ahead. So RPA commonly used in industries which are very systematic, which means the tasks are very repetitive in nature, very systemized tasks, right? That's why I use process in between. Process means every step is very much documented, very much defined, and things goes in similar way all the time. If you do 100 times, same steps you need to follow, same rules, same exceptions, same pattern, whether done by person A, person B, or person C. That is a good example of that. So you will see customer services, back office, you know, BPOs, call centers, accounting firms, financial services, which are include insurance, banking, mortgages, all sort of financial services, HR. So HR means, again, our back office side, recruitment, payroll, hiring, healthcare, again, a back office side. Back office means, you know, billing, reporting, data crunching, settlement, claims, supply chain management, again, a back office industry. So all these industries can use RPA because they have scope to have a systemized approach. They have a scope for automation, and they are having a lot of human inputs required, right? So all these human efforts will be mimicked by software. So the cost saving is more, the use cases are very good, and then applicability of robots or bots are very high. So we'll see some example. Very simple example here in HR department, right? So there is a company where a lot of people keep getting hired every week. Let's say 100 people are joining every week, right? It may be in NCR side, Bangalore, Mumbai, any big city, big factory, big office, 100 people. Now, every time somebody getting hired, HR team is doing all these steps. They're creating email account, adding to distribution list, you know, registering their phone extension, updating different software, creating the card, this access card, creating their different account on their different software, and sending informations to different department also and to the employee also to make persons, you know, onboarding ready. All these tasks, if you see in a normal process, so many software they need to use, so many systems to follow, so many processes to follow. Now what RPA does, that all this activity that person is doing, and this probably can take 3 hours time, or it may take even a full day, depend on your activities take time. If robot do same thing, because all this activity is happening where? On laptop or desktop or a PC, right? The person, HR is logging in, HR system doing something, HR is logging into visiting system, HR is logging in biometrics, HR is logging in emails. All this happening in on desktop only. Now what software do or robot or bot will do? They will mimic the same action, what the human is doing or what this HR person is doing, and do the same action in the same way that we have designed or make this robot to work. So all this manual task, you will see all the sequence of tasks will be done by a robot. This is a common or very simple or easy use case that you can understand how the robot works. So what robot is doing? Robot is taking care of the task, which is manual in nature, repetitive in nature, very systematic in nature, and time consuming in nature. So this is what a robot is doing. So far, any question on this use case or any comment, any opinion? If you're watching this first time, definitely you will have some questions, some thoughts in mind. Feel free to share. There is no harm in that. Comfortable enough. let's move to next one. Right. So this was on HR side. Now there could be so many use cases in HR also, in payroll, in appraisal, in daily attendance, data crunching, right? So many things. Now this is on call center side, all sales department side, or customer service we call it in general. So again, somebody getting a task in hand, and then robot taking care of some of the tasks, and some of the tasks again taking care by human. So it between human bot interaction, right? So some tasks are done by bot, some tasks are done by human. Staff is doing the task which required a decision making, which required some sort of thinking. But any task which doesn't require thinking, it is very systematic, can be done fast by bot. That is on their side. Just an example, what bot is doing. Bot is checking duplicates, it finding, you know, doing the research, making offer, placing offer, canceling order. All these are done by bot itself, and human is doing where they need to check the result and move forward. So this is one example I'm just putting forward, just to invoke your thoughts, invoke your ideas in this. Any question, any thought on this, feel free to share. Because unless I get some feedback, I would not be sure whether, you know, you are having some problem in listening to me, or you finding some difficulty in understanding the ideas that I want to share with you. So please feel free to keep typing in your feedback. Now let's make to next slide, where another use case that cover. So in this case, I just want to give idea that how a process before RPA and after RPA looks like. Just an example here, in healthcare industry, this is a claim process, medical claim process. And in normal day, a normal office person or staff person in a BPO will be doing this kind of, they will receive claim, they will go through the forms and document, they will do the data entry, looking at those forms and data. They will follow certain rules, you know, based on the standard operating procedure that they have, and they will pass it on. And all this work will require time, right? Maybe 15 minutes time. All these are manual and systematic work, right? Now, if we include bot here, what bot will do? Bot will also do the same thing, but in a technical way. So it will read a form, which means it will scan forms. It will extract the data from there through OCR technology. It will directly input information in those systems and follow the same rule which a normal human being or normal employee will follow and proceed it on. How much time it will take to do the same thing compared to a full-time employee? Probably a minute. So it's saving a time. It's reducing all the human error, right? It increasing your auditability, because all steps, you know that it has been done. So reporting or auditability processing. Apply. One more difference between human and robot is employee or human can work 8 hours a day overtime. They can maybe 10 hours a day, right? But bots can work 24 hours without break. They don't need break. They don't get sick leave. You can work on three shifts. Same bot can work on three shifts continuously. So Pushpa is asking question, are we not taking away job from those who are good at repeating jobs only? They may not be capable of innovating thinking. So it's not about, innovative thinking. Just think this way. As an economy or as a society, we all are striving to be a knowledge-based society, right? Not the manual labor-based society. That is how the whole intention of technology is. Technology is there to improve human life quality, professional quality, personal quality, and we should strive for that. This is just a stage in that, right? Everybody is striving to reducing human effort, increasing the productivity of human, and that is where robots come. Any kind of automation, right? Any machines is to reduce human effort. Any automation is to reduce human effort. Whether it is a simple calculator, a simple fan, or high-tech machine. Everything is to reduce human effort. And it is also in the same boat. So everything that you right now using, that definitely reducing somebody's effort in the past, right? But now we adopt it. So let's move ahead. Now let's see. So what are the we have seen some use cases before, after. What are the benefits of RPA, right? If you employ RPA in a business side, if business side get benefit, it will increase productivity. Reliability is very high because human emotion or human way of working is not there. Consistent, because it will follow all the rules consistently without fail. Non-invasive. Non-invasive means it doesn't need to recreate the whole software for you or whole processes for you. It will work on the already existing software, all the existing application and systems, online system, offline system. It will work all available platform right now. Compliance, yes, because it's follow the same process, and again it's very easy to find it's compliant. Low technology barrier means it is easy to learn and it can be very fast to implement, because these are not very high in, it doesn't require a very in-depth technical programming or you can say like long development cycle. So this is a general benefit of RPA in general. So I'm just taking a pause here. Let me take a couple of feedback or questions and then we'll continue. So RPA, it's just like any other technology to make life easier, right? Now, new words which are coming in RPA, let's move ahead. New words which comes in RPA is digital worker. You will hear this word a lot, digital employee, digital assistant. You see the chatbots are coming, or when you calling bank, you will have interactive voice response from there, that other side. You have Alexa, all these are what? Digital assistant, digital employee, or digital worker. And these are nothing but having RPA underneath that. So this is where the RPA versus human discussion always goes. You know, why RPA is important? Why companies are, you know, having physical robots? Why you have CCTV cameras, right? Because there is a reason, right? You can't keep one person 24 hours a day sitting on your door watching it, right? Now you have CCTV camera, that is automation, home automation, right? So 24 hours a day, bots can work 24 hours a day, full productive time, hardly makes any mistakes, hardly goes down, no PTOs, and they take care of general tasks. What human can do, humans generally involve in cognitive tasks, creative tasks, decision-making tasks, influencing tasks, right? Those kind of tasks. So that is where the RPA versus human discussion goes here. Perfect. So let's see if I see any comments, or shall we move ahead? Any questions on this side? I still want to know, continue to get your feedback. So we have 46 participants here. So definitely I want to see some more feedback, some more continuous interaction, so we can move ahead. Hope this interactions is you finding useful. So let's continue. If it is bore, let me know. I can, you know, make it more interesting with more example or more stories, but I need that kind of feedback continuously. Okay, so let's see some more example. I hope I'm making this interesting now. So now more example, right? And we have seen in the healthcare, we have seen in HR, now we see in financial services. So just an accounting department point of view, they do all this reconciliation. They do on a weekly basis, they do on a monthly basis, and all these are very tedious job. In a normal company, like 15 to 20 staff required only for reconciliation department. If bot is there, two bots can do all this work in like 3 hours time or 4 hours time for the whole month. So reconciliation of GL, banking system, payment, finding a duplicate payment, finding the all the issues right now can be done by RPA bot, which required a lot of human interaction. So this is just an example of on that case. So in short, what I'm trying to say is that any process where RPA is possibly fit, it has the all use cases, whether it is supply chain, whether it is healthcare, whether it is back office automations, whether it is ERP, it can take care of all this tasks. Now let's move to interesting topic, right? So this is what I established. What is RPA? What is business use cases? Where the industry using RPA? Now, what are the different product, right? That would be the primary questions from a student, like how we can learn RPA? What are the products we should learn? How to build our knowledge? What are the career options? How we get into this, right? So let's go into that part. So we cover our first half. Now the second half is all about RPA product. So I just want to, before I move to next slide, if you know any RPA product or you heard about it, just type your name, just type that product name. So I just know that what are your awareness right now. Anyway, I'm going to show and share with you. But if somebody knows already something, it would be interesting to know. Great, Geetaji. UiPath. Yep. We're going to see all about UiPath also. Right, the way you see, right? You people are mentioning NLP, then you must be knowing some product which implement NLP, blockchain, you must be knowing, you know, some product to use blockchain, AI ML. So similarly, RPA is a concept. It need to have some tools, technology framework to implement those. Okay, so I want some names if you are aware. If you are not aware, you can say I'm not aware, right? Even see, automation is so simplistic. You can say even office, out of office rule is automation, right? Just a simple example. Do you think RPA is limited in capability when compared to AI's unattended end-to-end automation? So unattended automation is nothing but RPA, and which nowadays trend is to include artificial intelligence in that. Pega, yes, Pega is also a platform. So let's quickly go through that. So these are the top 10 software product as of now, as of 2020. These are soft products. So what is the one? Automation Anywhere, UiPath, Blue Prism. These are the top three product that used in industry right now. Automation Anywhere, you will surprise, Automation Anywhere is the Indian company. And if you're hearing this first time, they have head office in Ahmedabad. And they are the one of the largest vendor in Automation Anywhere. So if somebody says that, you know, we don't have the big companies in technology in from India, now you know the at least one company additional name that they are Ahmedabad based company. They are the number one in RPA or technology automation. UiPath is European based, Blue Prism is US based, and then you will see some other vendors are there: WorkFusion, Pega, Antwerk, Cofex, Nice, Crayon, Edgework. So all these are different vendors. Obviously, top three covers almost 40% of market, and rest of cover, you know, remaining market. And beyond that, in this slide, you will see that so many other companies also, but you see you are in Automation Anywhere in the blue section. Core RPA capability. So these are one which are really a core RPA product. Means they are designed for the RPA function. Rest of product you will see they are for the different tools. ERP, productivity tools, BPM. BPM is workflow automation. So you might be seeing all these names first time. No problem in that, right? But at least now you are aware, right? WorkFusion. Now one question to all of you, just a general knowledge question. There is a one RPA company that recently bought by Microsoft. It was a very big software RPA company, which in last month acquired by Microsoft. If anybody who knows general knowledge in technologies should answer this, this is not any prizes, but I want to know if you guys are aware in market, which technology company got acquired by Microsoft in last month. And that was very specific to RPA. Okay, so let me tell the answer. You see on the orange side, Softmotive. Softmotive is a company which got acquired. Great. So I see some answer here. Great guys. So I really happy to see answer. You guys are very well aware. Softmotive is a company which acquired by Microsoft. So now Microsoft is also coming in RPA field. They already have power automated tool, power flow they call, but now Softmotive, now they are coming big way in RPA market also, and you see all other tools also. Now this is the all tools, right? So we're going to see how you can learn all these tools in coming slide. But before that, as somebody was questioning about AI and all, so what are the trends in RPA now 2020, right? RPA is, we understand, it's a basic automations, process automation without human interventions. Bot will be there, they will do this and that. Now what are the trends are right now going on? So trends, generally we calling it hyper automation, means hyper automation on a steroid, right? Automations on acceleration, that is called hyper automation. So which include artificial intelligence, you know, getting putting together with RPA, machine learning is coming in picture, good BPM tools are coming inside, analytics is coming in, native integrations are coming in, process mining is coming big way. So all these are emerging trends. That's why you will see that some products are in some area good, some products are good in some other area, because they are focusing on different trends. So that is how the trends in. So if somebody say, oh, what is the future of RPA? Future is good because it's now emerging and it's now getting aligned with all these other emerging technology also, IoT, right? So probably RPA will integrate with IoT. It can integrate with e-commerce, right? All these are, you know, there are so many upcoming trends. So these are the main highlighted one which I'm showing, that it is now integrating, and now we using word called hyper automation or extreme automation, cognitive automation, any words that any company can use, but these are the trend. Now come the interesting part, right? That is what you guys are waiting for, that what are the career option, right? I already shows this one, that career option is here. Now what you will learn, what roles you will play, let's quickly go there. So if once you develop your career in that, your team structure, your RPA role will look like this. Either you will be designer, you will be developer, administrator, or leader. This is how you will play a team role in coming year if you choose RPA as your career. What are the different role you can play? Just an example, you can be RPA developer. That means you have expertise on a certain product, certain tool, RPA architect, so you understand the designing part, technical part, business analyst, right? If you have the business knowledge, domain knowledge, and have this technology bandwidth to learn, then business analyst. Implementation manager means project manager, somebody who manage the team, who manage this work. Infrastructure engineer, who will take care of all this technical, deep technical aspect related to RPA, RPA support, right? So all this will be different RPA role that you can think of your career moving in different way. Obviously we'll see, and this is some of the skills that I am just putting forward, that if you thinking your career to be in RPA, you need to develop over period of time, not this month, not this year, but you have to think that in next 5 years you have to develop these kind of skills, then your career in RPA would be very, very successful, and you will have a very better productive and very good career, right? So strong problem solving skills, you have to expertise on certain tools, certain extent of programming knowledge, your problem solving, analytical knowledge, methodologies, project management. So you should learn all these 5 or 6 areas to improve and make your career better. So guys, this comfortable. Now you are aware that what kind of roles you will play, what kind of different career path you can choose, and how you can learn. Now coming to the real part, how you going to start, how you can start and learn RPA. So I'm going to show a few ways that you can start your journey. All are free. Good part is nowadays everything is free. Gyan ki ganga beh rahi hai, jisko jitne lote bharne hai bhar sakta hai. So everything is free. Only thing is required, internet connection, a good laptop, and lot of time from your side and motivation. Just an example, UiPath. You want to learn UiPath? I recommend it. Yes, you go to this site called academy.uipath.com, and you will see all courses are there. For the beginner level courses also there. For the business analyst level courses are there. For the engineer level courses are there. and all these courses are free. So my voice is having some problem right now, guys. Please, I think Vishal sir is saying that there is some voice problem. So please let me know if I'm speaking fast or interruption is coming. Okay. Okay, guys, so let's continue. So I'm just showing the UI path, right? So you can go to this UI path. If you have a notepad right now with you, or if you are attending this on laptop, you can just note down this this URL. You can go there, you can sign up, it's all free. It doesn't require any money, it doesn't require credit card, it required only your time. The more time you can spend, the more. As a student, you can build your resume, you can build your skills, you can do all the certification which are free also. So UiPath, great. Now, automation anywhere. university.automationanywhere.com. You see, they have their courses free. You can get your at least first level of understanding courses first done, and you finding interesting, then go into deep dive into technical learning. Certifications, virtual courses, guided path for each role, right? As a business user, as a developer, as a IT, as a student, faculty also, there are some courses. So that is build your awareness. So guys, you finding useful, please type some comment so I get some real time feedback from you. Blue Prism, that was the third product that I was showing, right? I wanted to show only for these three products because there are so many products. Each product have their own learning sites and all, but these three products are very known and you can learn all this free. Again, blueprism.com/university, you can go and you will see all these courses. You see this certifications, batches are there. And in some cases, they may ask you money for the certification, but in a lot of cases, all the basic level, student level, beginner level courses and certification exams all are free. And that is what you need, right? You require a laptop. Good laptop means like, I would say 4GB RAM and maybe like 2-3 years old laptop, not older than that. And good internet connection. You can build automation by yourself in 1 month. That is how it is. And that is where you need to update your resume that yes, you build three automations projects and these two certificate. That is good enough in your resume in coming months. Now let's so these are three product I shown you. If you find these three interesting, I have some additional bonus for you. So for that, I need your comment that you finding this useful and you need bonus. If you need bonus, just type yes, you need bonus also. Then I will show that. Otherwise, we can stop here also. So UiPath, Automation Anywhere, Blue Prism, we already done. I have few more bonus to show. If I get some feedback, I will show those bonuses also. Because now learning is, see, now there was a one saying, right, in Three Idiot movie. Seekhne ke liye aapko sirf uniform ki zarurat hai, paise ki zarurat nahi hai. Matlab ye, if you want to learn, you just need today only a mindset. Uniform is what? It's mindset. You need a mindset and you will learn. So let me show some bonuses also. If you find this interesting, go and take it. It is not related to IP. It is in general for every student, every faculty member, every friends you can share. TCSIronHub.in, right? If you already have, go and sign up for this website. They have all these courses which are good for students, for the career oriented courses, free. You see, I have this screenshot I just took yesterday night only. So all these courses are free. It is designed for internships. It is designed for students. It is designed for faculty members. Go and use this. It is free from TCS. Ample amount of content is there. All are good quality. Even we as an organization are using it. All the fresher employees are using this site to build their skills also. Just see, you see, there's a good course right now going on, Knockdown the Lockdown. And that is a set of 12 courses put together as a program. So just a session, if you finding, if you don't like RPA, then also you can go and join this one. Swayam, this is a great website and platform to get a great learning, you will see that bottom side, IIM, Bangalore, IGNU, AICT, all these organizations are building their courses there. You can sign up. Exam is only like what, 1200 rupees or 1300 rupees. And all these are really certification courses. It covers everything. It is for faculties, students, professionals. Even I'm doing one course from here. So it's like a 3 months courses. They have live classes, they have assignment, they have exam, a proper exam, and then you get a proper certification also. So if you feel motivated, encourage you, your friends who are living in a village also, they can, you know, go through only based on mobile phone also. Other thing for professionals, which we are using, this 90 days of Skillsoft access. Right now, because of corona situation, they're giving this 90 days are free. And you can go and sign up this URL. Now, what is the difference between this versus TCS, IIM, and SWAM? You will see all these high-end technical courses. On left side, I'm just showing the screenshot that what is the library content looks like. You name it, and you will have courses for that. And you can learn in 1 hour to, let's say, 7 days courses. You will get batches, you will get certificate, you will get everything to display your learning also, showcase your learning also for 90 days. If you have a, education email, then you get 90 days. If you don't, then you get 2 months also. 2 months is also enough, 3 months is enough. You can earn so much in terms of learning from here. Shastika's question is, sir, certifications are free, but exam have fees? No. UiPath have the certification and exam both are free. Automation Anywhere, I think, have the some exam fees, $75, which also you can waive off if you are a student. There are so many. And all these are free, actually. See, a certification, in some cases, you need to pay. But UiPath, I know those are free because my team is doing that, and they do every quarter. SWAM is having some charges like 1200 rupees for exam. That is also after 3 months, once you finish your assignment and courses and everything. And that is a real certificate from IIM Bangalore or, all those proper colleges. TCS/IIM is totally free, no money at all. Skillsoft, 90 days free, no money at all. Whether learn.skillsoft is paid. Yes, I'm sharing the link actually. You have to go to this business-continuity-edu-trial.html. You go this page, give your email ID, maybe college email ID if you required. Otherwise, you can try with your Gmail or regular email account also. So these are the bonuses. These are not related to RPA, but as a student, you can get benefit from this. Other good thing I'm finding is Coursera. Coursera is giving almost 100 courses free. I just selected for you guys. There is this section called free course, free courses college students. So you see all these courses from University of Buffalo, Princeton are right now free, and certification is also free. If you complete your assignments and submitted those assignments, attend those live classes, those are weekly classes, you can get your certification, will improve your knowledge on that. So I hope this bonus is useful. Initial RPA is useful, and as a career you will getting right. So what we have done so far, we have what is RPA, how it is used in business cases, what are the different product, new trends in RPA, what are the career option, how you can learn RPA, right? So this is what we cover in almost like last 50 minutes, and you were very patient to listening me, so I appreciate that. Now I am open for questions, so you can ask any questions.